Hi everyone, welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. This video is going to begin the first of a two-part series on building a JSON web service. So we're going to go ahead and look at how to do that in Scriptcase using JSON, using a web service based on JSON. So my name is Nate Carpenter and I am the instructor leading these tutorials. So this video is going to be part one, as I said, and we're going to be looking at kind of JSON web service basics. What a web service is, what JSON is, and then the basics of how to set up a web service. And then in the next video, we'll look at some more complex advanced functionality for your web service. So first, what is a web service? I'm going to keep this pretty simple. There's a lot of different ideas on what a web service is, a lot of different definitions. So I'm going to keep it pretty generic so that we can get started with actually developing here soon. So I've got three different statements here that kind of narrow it down. One, it's a way for devices to communicate over the internet. So that's pretty general. That could talk about a lot of different things such as the HTTP protocol, FTP, etc. So I'm going to make that a little more specific and say a way to make a resource available over the internet. So resource can be a lot of things. It can be exposure to a payment processing service or some sort of dynamic data. And that's what we're going to be focusing on here. It's a way to send or transfer data over the internet. So FTP could do that to some degree, but this allows us to have more dynamic data as opposed to static data that's just sitting on a hard drive. So that's what we're going to do for this, and I'll show you in a bit what we're going to do, what data we're going to transfer, how we're going to use Scriptcase Grid application actually to do that. So that's what a web service is in general terms. Now, what is JSON? So maybe you don't know what that is. So JSON is a way for data to be formatted in order to be exchanged over the internet or some other way. And it's data format that's human readable. You see in a bit. And so it's very easy to read from a human perspective, but it's also machine readable. It's also easy for the computer to read the build programs, to parse it and process it. And in fact, we really don't need to do a whole lot of parsing of the JSON. Our programming language that we use comes built in with tools to do that. So here's an example of what it looks like. As you can see, I've got some different colors here. So everything in the red is kind of the punctuation that holds the structure together. So the whole thing is surrounded by these curly braces here. And so that's what everything in JSON is going to be surrounded by here. And then as you can see here in the green is our field name. So we've got three fields, name, age, and city, like so. And then separating the field names from the field values is some more punctuation, these colons right here. So these red colons, separating those. And then everything in this orange here are the field values. So John Smith, 31, New York. So that's what's actually stored in those fields. And then we have commas there separating the fields. So as you can see, there's a lot of white space in here. There's new lines, there's some spaces in here. And that's all included in the JSON. That's what makes it human readable. It's actually included as part of that, but the machine, the computer, when it parses it, just ignores that part, but the human side of you can see that and read that more easily. So that's what JSON is. That's what a web service is. So let's kind of look at the outline of these two videos here. So we're in part one, web service basics. So the first thing we're going to do is understand what web services and what JSON is. So we've already done that. We can check that off. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to look at how to receive and decode input from a request to a web service. And then we'll look at how to send and encode a response. So that's decoding and encoding JSON there. So responding to that request. And then we're also going to look at how to send a request. We're going to use Postman, and we're also going to use curl built into PHP. So Postman, we'll look at what that is in a minute, but that's optional. And then in the next video, we're going to look at how to handle different types of requests, multiple types of requests. We're going to look at how to get data for that request and parse and validate request data and then save request data. And then also respond with any successes and errors from that save operation and from the validation operations as well. So that's kind of our outline for what we're going to do in the two parts of this course. And then let's look at some components that we're going to need for this. So we're going to use a grid application. That's how we're going to get our data. And that's going to be used more in the next video, actually. We're going to use some blank applications to actually build a web service and to test a web service in. We're also going to use Postman software. That's optional, but it's a software for testing Testing APIs and testing web services can be really convenient when you're building this out. And then we're going to use some PHP programming. So I hope this is helpful for you. Even if you'd never build an actual web service, you're probably going to interact with a web service at some point. So that's why it's important to understand how someone would put this together so that when you're trying to learn the documentation and learn how to use a new web service in the future, you can kind of put yourself in the shoes of the developer, the other developer who built that web service, and kind of understand how that person would have gone about building this and designing this and setting it up. So it'll be easier for you to figure out how to do this. So now let's go over to Scriptcase and let's get started with developing our web service. Okay, so here we are. We have a grid application and we're going to look at this more in the next one. But for now, I'm going to export this to JSON format here to give you a sneak peek of what we're going to do in the next video to use this web service for. So I choose JSON. It's going to generate it here. Click View. And we're going to see all the data from that grid in JSON format already ready to go so we can use this. So that's kind of what some JSON looks like. So if you go back here, that's all that data right there in there. So you can see those field names, product ID, product name, quantity per unit, etc. showing up in that JSON. So the encode JSON, the create JSON, we're going to use this PHP function, JSON encode. And it just returns a JSON representation there. So we just pass it in some values. We're going to use an array. And it can be a few different things, but we're going to focus on using an array. And then it's just going to return a JSON object there that's going to be really useful for us. So there's an example of that, passing in an array A, B, C kind of as the fields. And then there's the JSON return that looks kind of like this JSON here, except more simple, obviously. So that's JSON encode to create JSON. And then if we receive JSON and want to decode it into something that's more human readable, we can use the JSON decode function. So this is pretty similar, except it does the opposite here. So it takes the JSON and then returns it as an object or as an array. And that's what we're going to do with this associative parameter right here. If we mark that as true, it's going to return an associative array that's very easy for us to process and read from a programmatic standpoint. So that's encode and decode functions here and how we're going to use those. So we're going to use those over on our programming. So let's go over there. I've got a blank application set up, web service PHP JSON, and it's just a blank application, just a place to put some code. So now we can make this do whatever we want. So let's go ahead and copy in this first element here. So as you can see, I've got three lines of code. Very simple. I'm getting the contents of whatever is sent in. So whoever made this request is sending some data. I'm getting that, saving it in a variable there. And then I'm sending a header back telling the receiver that we're sending some JSON back. And then we're decoding whatever was in that request using the JSON decode function there. So that way we've got our JSON set up and we can start doing some processing based on that. So the first thing I'm going to do is make sure that there was something sent in that JSON and that there was also a field there called request. That's going to tell us what we need to do, what the sender wants us to do. So as long as there's something in that request, then we can go ahead and do something. If there's nothing there, then we need to encode something, a status 404, that there's an error. And we're just putting this in an array, as you can see. And then an error, non-JSON body, or non-existent request. So there was no body or there was no request associated with that. So we put it in an array. And then we encode it and echo it, and that'll go back to the user so they can see that error. Now we're going to use a switch statement to process this request and see what we're going to do. For now, we're just going to have one item here. So it's going to be a switch on that JSON request field right there. And our first case there is going to be instructions. So this is going to allow us to send some instructions back to the user for how to use this web service. So if the word instructions is in the JSON request field, then we're going to go ahead and echo out the same way here, an array with the field instructions and then some text there telling them how to use that. So those are those fields. I'm telling them to pass in product name, quantity per unit, and unit price. So they're going to pass in values for those fields. And then we can save the data in those fields to our database, to our products table. So then we're going to put a default case here. So if it's not one of the valid instructions or valid requests, we're going to send back another 404 error with that error message. So now if we generate this, we don't need to run it. We can just generate it and then it's ready to go. So now I have the Postman software I mentioned before. So as you can see, we have a request here. We have the URL of our application, and make sure you put the index.php after it so that you're calling the actual file here. So if I were to generate this, make sure I generate it so that it's ready to go. I'm not sure I did that quite before, so you always want to make sure you generate it and it's ready to go, so then the code is ready to run. Okay, so that is ready. If I send it, I'm going to get an error right there. So as you can see, there's our error formatted in JSON 404 non-existent body request. So if we go to the body field here, so as you can see, we have params, authentication, etc. But if you go to the body and choose raw, and then the type is going to be JSON here. So it's just sending raw text, but it's going to be formatted as JSON. And then we can build up some JSON. So we're doing the curly braces there, just like I showed you earlier. And field request in quotes with the colon. And then instructions is the value in that field. So that's the only thing we're sending in right now. Just that one field with that one value. And I go ahead and click send on that and I should get instructions back. And as you can see, I do. So there's our instructions right there. So that's how you do just a basic web service. That's very easy to set up. Sending a request and handling that on the other end. So as you can see, we're validating whether or not there is a request, but also the type of request because of this case statement with the default. So if we pass something in other than instructions here, we're going to get this error. So let's go ahead and go over to Postman again and test that error. So let me open up Postman here. And instead of instructions, you can just enter in whatever you want here. So I'm just going to enter in some random text, hit send, and I should get that error, invalid request. So that's a little bit more useful error. Now let's do add products. So that's something right now that's not built out. That's an invalid request. That's something we're going to use in the next one. But let's go ahead and build out a dummy case for that. So we're going to add another case in here for add products. So this is going to be very basic, just going to send an array back with some product values, just to kind of demo what we're going to do. The next one, we're going to take that JSON from the grid and insert that into a database. But you could enter in some values for the product ID, product name, and just kind of send those back for now as a dummy element. So then once that is done, we can go ahead and generate this and then go ahead and test it. So now when we put add products in, we shouldn't get an error, which is what we want because we're going to build out that functionality in the next video here. So now add products, and then we can go ahead and hit send on that. And there we go. So there we get our products array. So that's another array, the way we set up that, a subarray of all the products that we added. So that's how you handle a different type of request there. Now, as you can see, we're doing this in Postman, but what if you didn't want to use Postman, or what if you wanted to build a program to actually do this? There's a way to do that. If you go up the code here, you can actually generate all the PHP code you want. So you've got some different versions here, Node, Python, etc. We're going to use PHP. And let me just copy this and take it over to another blank application over in Scriptcase, and then we can talk about how it works. So this is all built in the Scriptcase. You could build this on your own. You wouldn't need Postman to do this, but Postman makes it easy for us. So we're going to new application and blank, choose our connection. Make sure I choose the right connection here. Probably doesn't matter. I'm not using it, but name it. So I'm going to name it JSON test, like so. Go ahead and click create on that. And just another blank application. Let me copy in that code I got from Postman. So we're using curl. Curl is an easy way to interact with different resources online. So in it, we're initializing the curl there. We're setting some options. So the URL, it's the same URL as before. We're telling it we are going to get a return here. So we're going to want that return, some encoding, max redirects, just some different parameters here. You can look at what they all do if they matter to you. Custom request is going to be post, and then post fields is going to be that JSON there. As you can see, it's got those new lines and those spaces in there, all that white space so that it's human readable. And then the header here is going to be an array. We're telling it that it's going to be JSON, and we've got some session IDs and language and stuff that's specific to Scriptcase that Postman figured out from the return there. And then we're good to go, so we can go ahead and execute that curl. Close it up when we're done, and then echo the response out to the screen to see what it is. So if we run this, we should get the same thing that we got before, maybe not formatted as nicely. And as you can see, there it is, result success, and then our product values there. So there we go. So that's built on that add products request, again, using the same way we did over in Postman, sorry. So that's how you build a basic web service handling a couple different requests and just sending some JSON data back. In the next one, we're going to look at some ways to actually add products using that JSON format from the grid that I showed you at the beginning. So I hope you stick around, and I'll see you in the next video.